Welcome to Usability and Human Factors Decision Support Systems, a Human Factors Approach. This is Lecture C. In this lecture, we will discuss an important topic to usability and human factors, Decision Support Systems, DSS, a Human Factors Approach. Decision support systems have been used in a variety of industries, including finance, transportation, and public works, since the 1970s. It had its beginning in health since the late 1950s, but became a more active area of research and development in the mid-1970s. With the growing penetration of clinical information systems, DSS is an effective vehicle for providing real-time guidance to clinicians. DSS includes lower technology solutions such as paper-based guidelines. However, we will focus on computer-based clinical decision support systems, CDSS, and computerized provider order entry systems. The objectives for this unit, Decision Support Systems, A Human Factors Approach, Lecture C, are to discuss the role of usability testing, training, and implementation of clinical decision support. Describe and define usability as it pertains to clinical decision support. This scenario was developed by Gil Cooperman and colleagues. It was published as an online data supplement in the Journal of the American Medical Informatics Association. It illustrates how a drug-drug interaction decision support scenario may work in the context of a CPOE system. I will read the scenario out loud. When ordering a new medication, a prescriber may not be aware that two drugs interact, or may not be keeping in mind the other medications that the patient is taking. As an example, consider the case of a hospitalized patient who is being treated with venlafaxine, Effexor, for chronic depression and develops an infection with a drug-resistant bacterium requiring treatment with linezolid, a new antimicrobial agent. The interaction between linezolid and venlafaxine, serotonin syndrome, altered mental status, including agitation, confusion, and coma, neuromuscular hyperactivity, and autonomic dysfunction, is very severe, but may not be known to the practitioner. While writing the order for linezolid, an alert screen can warn the practitioner that these two drugs should not be used together. The alert screen may offer the prescriber the opportunity to cancel the order, to discontinue the existing medication that interacts with the newly ordered medication, or to order a test that could detect the interaction or monitor therapy. The alert screen may prompt the physician to have a conversation with the patient regarding potential side effects on the medications. Any of these consequences of the decision support software could be beneficial. In this scenario, the CDSS flags a potentially serious problem by alerting the clinician and offering a set of alternative actions, including canceling the order and offering constructive suggestions to raise the awareness of potential side effects with the patient. This example illustrates the nature of an interaction with a system and a positive outcome. As we discuss later, some interactions are less successful. There are well-known challenges associated with the implementation and use of CPOE systems. The systems are not easy to learn. They impose their own workflow on clinical care. This may be disruptive and even interfere with normal channels of communication. For example, a clinician might have previously had a conversation with the pharmacist prior to deciding on a medication regimen for a complicated patient problem. The CPOE system may serve to reduce the likelihood of such a conversation. In fact, pharmacists who may once have had considerable influence on therapeutic decision-making may be reduced to dispensing medication. These systems often take more time than paper ordering, at least until clinicians develop substantial facilities with the new system. The most important potential problem is the possibility of new types of error. This slide recaps the essential dilemma of CPOE systems at this point in time. There is presently a substantial body of literature on CPOE systems and the use of CDS systems. CPOE has been characterized as an important intervention to reduce prescribing errors, and yet the evidence base for their effectiveness is limited thus far. On one hand, some studies have shown electronic prescribing with CPOE significantly increases prescribing quality in hospital inpatients. However, they have also been shown to introduce new types of errors in the decision-making process. We are now going to discuss a couple of studies that document problems associated with the use of CPOE systems and decision support. This first one is by Jan Horsky and colleagues. He studied the interaction with particular CPOE system in view to characterize the interaction in terms of effectiveness, changes to ordering behavior, opportunities for error attributable to the interaction process. The example described in the publication involves decision support for heparin dosing, a medication that is used to reduce blood clotting, an anticoagulant. The dose is based on a calculation of the patient's weight. Horsky used a set of artificial scenarios designed to elicit decision support responses. The CPOE triggers a decision support alert and calculates the dose automatically. The study employed a cognitive walkthrough analysis conducted by expert analysts. They also conducted a usability testing experiment in which physicians were asked to enter appropriate orders according to a clinical scenario using a CPOE system. The scenario required a drug dose adjustment for an ongoing anticoagulation therapy. Subjects were instructed to verbalize their thoughts or think aloud while completing the task. Their interaction with the system was captured on video. This is the CPOE screen seen by the clinicians. In the scenario, they were in the midst of ordering and an alert screen popped up. Let's take a closer look at the alert screen. Alerts are often constituted by remarkably complex messages. The critical information is that the appropriate dose should be a bolus of 8,000 units. But the key information is embedded in an extended text and not readily visible amidst the busy message. Not surprisingly, the clinicians experienced difficulty drawing the correct inference from the alert. This resulted in considerable confusion and extended periods of time to process the alert. The alert was not aligned with typical workflow. In one case, a subject performed all the calculations by hand, and six others used the values only as a reference. Subjects also experienced some difficulty understanding how the system performed the computation and were skeptical about its veracity. The format of presentation of the alert was clearly suboptimal. In general, the benefits of decision support were not realized. Part of the problem is that the CDSS process was not consistent with typical workflow patterns. The author suggests that a different representational form would enable a quick perceptual judgment and could reduce the extra cognitive effort. For example, if the alert would include only the calculated dose in the frame with a clear description of how the result was computed. It would also be helpful to differentiate suboptimal configurations on the screen and replace them with displays based on sound usability principles. Admittedly, this is harder than it seems. The study by Horsky and colleagues identified some problems associated with decision support and CPOE workflow. In 2005, Koppel and colleagues published a very influential study examining the ways in which a CPOE system facilitated medical errors. The study, which was published in JAMA, Journal of the American Medical Association, used a series of methods, including interviews with clinicians, observations, and a survey to document the range of errors. According to the authors, the system facilitated 22 types of medication error, and many of them occurred with some frequency. The errors were classified into two broad categories. 1. Information errors generated by fragmentation of data and failure to integrate the hospital's information systems, and 2. Human-machine interface flaws reflecting machine rules that do not correspond to work, organization, or usual behaviors. We are going to illustrate the first class of errors with two subcategory examples. It is a well-known phenomenon that users come to rely on technology and often treat it as an authoritative source that can be implicitly trusted. In this case, clinicians relied on CPOE displays to determine the minimum effective dose or a routine dose for a particular kind of patient. However, there was a discrepancy between their expectations and the dose listing. The dosages listed on the display were based on the pharmacy's warehousing and not on clinical guidelines. For example, although normal dosages are 20 or 30 milligrams, the pharmacy might stock only 10 milligram doses, so 10 milligram units are displayed on the CPOE screen. Clinicians mistakenly assumed that this was the minimal dose. Medication discontinuation failures are a commonly documented problem with CPOE systems. The system expects a clinician to 1. Order new medications, and 2. Cancel existing orders that are no longer operative. Frequently, clinicians fail to cancel the existing orders, leading to duplicative medication orders. As a result, the possibility of medical errors is increased. Perhaps a reminder that prior orders exist and possibly need to be canceled may serve to mitigate this problem. As is the case with other clinical information systems, CPOE systems suffer from a range of usability problems. We will now look at 3 kinds of problems. First, when selecting a patient, it is relatively easy to select the wrong patient because names and drugs are close together, the font is small, and patients' names do not appear on all screens. Second, physicians can order medications at computer terminals not yet logged out by previous physicians. This can result in either unintended patients receiving medication or patients not receiving the intended medication. When patients undergo surgery, the CPOE system cancels their previous medications. Physicians must re-enter CPOE and reactivate each previously ordered medication. Once again, a reminder to do so may serve to reduce the frequency of such mistakes. The Koppel study is well worth reading. It has received considerable acclaim and notoriety. It is worth pointing out that the CPOE system employed in that study used an old-style interface and was not consistent with modern graphical user interfaces. Nevertheless, this system was widely used, and several of the problems noted in this study have also been observed in the use of other systems. Earlier in the lecture, we were introduced to decision biases. Biases reflect systematic deviations from normative standards and lead to skewed or imbalanced decisions. An automation bias is a preference to lean on technology. In this case, following the directions of a decision support system, even if those directions do not correspond with one's intuition or training. This can lead to 2 classes of errors. 1. Errors of omission, as in the case where a clinician is less vigilant in checking drug orders because they assume the computer will already have done the work. And 2. Errors of commission, in which clinicians tacitly assume that if they were not warned about a potentially dangerous drug order by the computer, then there is nothing to worry about. The opposite of automation bias is an anti-automation bias, which is characterized by a distrust or disdain for computer advice, such as alerts and reminders. This often leads to advice being ignored. Clinicians routinely disable or ignore the alarms and alerts that clinical monitoring devices have. Sometimes the reasons are legitimate. For example, some systems exhibit high false alarm rates for their alerts. Other times, clinicians simply do not want to be disrupted by intrusive alerts and readily dismiss them without giving the advice its proper due. Overriding of alerts is a pervasive problem in the use of CPOE systems. Some studies have documented override rates of over 90%. This concludes Lecture C of Unit 7, Decision Support Systems, A Human Factors Approach. To summarize, CDSS have also been shown to introduce new types of errors in the decision-making process. Usability testing and cognitive walkthrough analysis have been conducted by expert analysts to study CDSS. In the study discussed, CPOE system facilitated 22 types of medication error.